place not long ago. Downstairs was pretty open. It's for my music. I don't want people to, you know, hear me drumming or playing my bass or guitar or whatever. Or worse yet, my singing. Yeah, as I go, I'm gonna be just giving you some ideas and what to look out for. Like a drop saw is gonna be good, help you out. Circular saw, some clamps, with the tacks. So these are really handy. An impact wrench with the correct fitting. Alright, now unfortunately my ground is all unlevel, so it's been a little bit of a pain. Basically I've just joined all the links across the floor. To join all my timbers, just little brackets, L brackets, uprights, so they're really handy. The brick wall here, so I've left a little bit of a gap in case I want to block that off later on down the track. So little things to think about like that as you're going. So as you can see, I've used non-structural timbers. Unless you're building it permanently, you could probably choose some more expensive stuff, but it's pretty cheap. You get a length of 2400 for about $2.70. So that's what I've chose to go with, and to do it fast, put it together with tech heads. I've gone and done all the framework. The wall I'm using here is 12 mil, 1200 sheets by 24 of particle board. So that'll help absorb the CM and, you know, it's got a little bit of stability, easier to work with. Back wall, made out of fibro. So I'm building my studio. I didn't want to be sitting in there, breathing in the dust, asbestos, you know, I'm worried that's what it is. So I've sealed off all along the back wall there. So I blocked off the back wall, got power points, I've thought about it. My table's gonna lie across from that section to that section. This section in the front's gonna be where my door is. So before I got too far, I wanted to just take a little bit of video just to show you that it's not as hard as what you think it may be, or costly if you do it yourself. All these pieces of wood and whatnot, screws, brackets, $500. So there's still a little bit more to spend, but you know, it's kind of good. It gives you a bit of a project. You can lay out your entire scheme of how you want your booth to run. So in that section there, my booth's gonna be stepping out. I've got a glass window right about there, and it's gonna be looking straight back at my table where all my monitors are gonna be, speakers, all that. So if I'm in there myself, I can actually look back from the booth, control it from in there, do my recording, press record while I'm inside the booth. I can see it going, and you know, everything's all linked up. This section here, you know, like we're in Queensland, so it's gonna get pretty bloody hot. So I'm chucking the aircon in. So I'm just gonna be making up some braces through there. I'll stand it up because there's a hot water system sitting right behind it and the fibro there. So I'm just gonna try and offset it far away from the fibro and at a height where the heat that comes out of the booth doesn't blow into the hot water system. I've left a notched out section here, so no one complains. There's a good 1200 side to side from where the hot water system is. So once that wall goes in, the aircon will sit, blow air from above where the hot water system is. Plenty of room to get in there in case anyone needs to do any servicing on the hot water system. get when you're doing your uprights, beams coming across, you want to step them up just like I've done, so you can run a couple ticks straight through and then drop it back down. Keep following that around. Watch for beams. So that's why a circular saw will be real handy for you. Just little things to think about like that. If you do have unlevel concrete, like what I have here, it's probably a bit hard to see, but I got like old bricks and everything like running through, going up with your beams, support braces. So what I had to do when I was running my wood was make sure that when I put my wall panel in, it slots into the gap. Then when it comes up, how much of a gap are you gonna have between your support pillars? So as you can see, I'm not a builder or nothing, but it's come up pretty straight. Runs with the cabling. So always look up, see where you're drilling. Make sure you don't cut any electrical cables. But yeah, I'll keep you posted. Hopefully this is, you know, a bit of a good help in case you're thinking of doing the same thing. My next take of a video, you'll see the progress right up until I'll finish this. Alright, speak to you soon.